Boys got off to a great start, solid opening stand, and another 50 for the captain.
Yeah, no, I thought both Daniel and Anton played extremely well. They, you know, took some very good options. Made use of obviously what is a very big ground here at Agley Oval, and really set us up for a big title.
A lot of sixes today, a lot of purple out there. Good entertainment, I thought, for the crowd.
Yeah, definitely. No, there was a lot of sixes hit, and say on a reasonably big ground, even though there was one end that was a little bit shorter than the other. It's it's entertaining cricket, I guess. But then you have a look at the bowlers and just have a look at the areas that they bowl. But I think, you know, what is for sure is it was a very good cricket wicket.
Ronnie Hera looked very dangerous opening the batting for the Canterbury Kings. Good wicket to get him.
Always, because he's a dangerous player. You're not quite sure exactly what you're going to get from him. He backs away at times and then he baseballs it straight. So he's a dangerous player because, you know, you just got to stay unpredictable because you never know what might happen. But you know that you're going to get a chance with him. You just got to take that chance.
What did you make of your fielding performance, the bowling fielding today?
The bowling, it wasn't as good as what we've bowled in the past, but you know, you get put under pressure and you react in certain ways. I thought the fielding was solid. Ground fielding was good. We took a couple of good catches. Scott Coogline nearly pulled off a great catch in the deep, but happy with the fielding. But the bowling, I thought, you know, we were put under pressure and didn't always respond in the right manner. But then, you know, you look at John R. Bolt, especially through the middle and at the end there, I thought he was outstanding. And for Scott Coogline to come back and pick up those vital wickets when he did, I think over 17, you know, that was a big over. So I'm really delighted for Jono and Scott to have really influenced this game, where, you know, we usually think we're going to have to rely on Dan or Ben Lachlan, whereas today it was Jono and Scott who did a fine job for us.